Good afternoon. And we are here once again with more dangerous illegal guns seized off the streets of our city. I would like to thank Commissioner Bealefeld and the men and women of the Baltimore City Police Department for their continued focus on illegal guns and the violent criminals who use them. I would personally like to thank Officer Rodriguez, Officer Petriak, Officer Leek, Officer King, Major Booker, Lieutenant Dombrowski, Lieutenant Branford, Detective Sergeant Mileto, and Detectives Boyd and Lind. Without the hard work and collaboration between our Violent Crime Impact Division and Patrol, this arrest would not have happened. Thank you all for your teamwork. Because of your efforts and the efforts of your fellow officers, Baltimore is making great progress in reducing gun violence. In 2010, homicides were down 6%, making it the lowest homicide rate since lowest homicide count since 1985. Gun homicides were down 13%. Overall gun crime was down 16%, and non-fatal shootings down 42% since 2000. Your hard work is paying off, and in showing everyone that Baltimore can be a safer city. We all know that we need to do more. When you look at this table today, you see why Maryland legislators must act now to create tougher penalties for illegal gun possession. The current laws are inadequate and support a culture of tolerance for these dangerous illegal guns that you see here today. This must end. My administration is sponsoring two state bills aimed at cracking down on gun offenders who, like Michael Nichols, end up serving very little jail time. 44% of homicide suspects in 2010 have prior gun arrests. Yet 82% of all jail time imposed by Baltimore's district courts for gun offenders charged with misdemeanor gun possession, 82% of that time was suspended. And the average amount of jail time served by misdemeanor gun offenders is only 4 months. And gun offenders like Michael Nichols, who get sentenced to 5 years, too often only serve half of their sentence. My first bill would make gun possession a felony, and create a minimum sentence of 18 months for all defendants arrested with an illegal loaded gun. It's a simple message. If you were caught with an illegal loaded gun, you go to jail. The second bill would strengthen sentencing options for felons in possession of a gun with a tougher sentencing range of 5 years minimum to a 15-year maximum. This gives the judges more sentencing options when faced with a violent repeat offender like Mr. Nichols. I am urging everyone, business leaders, community leaders, everyday citizens who care about the future of Baltimore, to join me in Annapolis this year as we fight for tougher gun laws so we can continue to reduce gun violence in Baltimore and in the state of Maryland. Thank you very much. I'd like to bring up Commissioner Bealefeld.
Thank you, Mayor. So last night, our officers in the Western District received a call from a concerned citizen, exactly what we've been advocating for. The citizen had observed an armed person take an assault weapon into a house and contacted us, and our officers responded. They went to the house and they knocked on the door, and 31-year-old Michael Nichols, you have his photo there, climbed out of a second floor rear window in an attempt to flee from my police officers. During the process, the officers observed Nichols discard a large bag of suspected marijuana, and the officers acted quickly and took him into custody. The officers didn't stop there. They obtained and executed search warrants and found three guns, the guns you see before you. One was a loaded Tech-9 assault pistol and two loaded .45 caliber semi-automatic handguns, both you see before you. Nichols is a convicted felon with a lengthy criminal record dating back to the late 1990s. His most recent arrest was in April of 2007 for possession of a firearm, drug distribution, and assault. He received a five-year sentence, but only spent three of those years behind bars. At the urging of our state partners, Nichols was denied parole in 2009 for these offenses. But based on our existing laws, the correction system was mandated to release him on July 2nd, 2010. And now, merely 6 months later, the men and the women of the Baltimore Police Department are doing their duty again, standing in defense of the city, and arrested him with this small arsenal. This case is yet another example of why we need the mayor's stronger sentencing laws for gun offenders. This year, the mayor and I will continue to advocate relentlessly in Annapolis for tougher penalties for gun offenders like Mr. Nichols. First, I want to thank the good citizen who called police about this dangerous gun criminal and encourage all the residents of Baltimore to let us know when you see these bad guys with guns in your neighborhoods. We will respond. We will arrest them. And we will get these guns out of your communities. I want to thank the officers who responded. Officer Linda Rodriguez, who's here today, and she responded, took the initial call for service, and her quick response and diligent action enabled us to secure this very valuable evidence and make the city safer, as well as her sergeant and her district commander, Major Robert Booker, and all the officers in the Western District and VSIS who assisted in this arrest. I want to thank them for helping all of us keep our city's streets safer. And thank you guys for coming today. Thank you.